Hi guys, Alex here, and welcome back to my channel. If you've not already, make sure you subscribe to see more of my content. Also, check the links in the description. Today, I want to tell you guys a funny story about my first date that I went since after my breakup. But yeah, I'm taking care of my car today as well. So as you can tell, I'm having my car washed and I'm inside the car. But yeah, so I'm going to get the car washed and after that I'm going to head home. I need to get some food actually, I'm starving. I met this guy online and we started chatting. We exchanged Snapchat and Instagram and stuff like that and we started talking. He is from Czech Republic, I think. Romania, Czech Republic. And he told me that he has been in the UK for 2-3 years and his English wasn't that good. So I was like, yeah, it's fine. We seem to be understanding each other. So it's all good. Your English seems to be good enough. So he decided to invite me over that we should go out, like clubbing. I then drove to his place and I was waiting outside his house for him to come outside. He then came out saying that he's running a bit late and that his friends wants to join us. So I'll be with him and his friends. I was like, okay, sure, wherever. I was expecting it to be just the two of us. Just the two of us. Anyway, but yeah, fine. I don't mind your friends joining. Actually, I'm going to take a step back because when he came out to meet me in the car, I then realized that he could not speak a word of English. When he has been texting me, he has been using a translator. So when I text him back, he usually just copies and pastes my stuff into a translator to understand what I'm saying before he then replies. So when he was telling me that, you know, his friends were going to join me and all, he was literally typing on his phone and showing me the translation. I will read it, type on my phone what I want to say and show him my phone with the translation. So the night suddenly changed from, you know, meeting someone, having a chat and having fun to struggling to communicate. But I was like, oh, fun and games, sounds interesting, it's gonna be a fun night, so whatever. He then came back after telling me that his friends were going to join us, remember, using his phone, that his mom was going to join us as well, that she loves to party and she doesn't want to miss out and she's fine with him being gay and he came out years ago and all the rest of it. And I was like, okay, fine, whatever. This was not what I was expecting, but I'm here, so whatever. The mom then joined us and they all go into my car. So I'm driving, him sitting next to me in front, his mom and two of his other friends, a boy and a girl, sitting at the back with the mom. We then drove, wait for it, to his mom's boyfriend's house and they wanted to go there for pre-drinks. So we got there and we started introducing ourselves and yes, the mom got drunk and she can't speak English, by the way. So the mom can't speak English, his two friends can't speak English. The mom's boyfriend is the only one that can speak English. So the mom got drunk and she refused to stop calling me beautiful. Literally, she's passed me a glass of wine like, drink, beautiful, you beautiful, drink. I'm like, no, I'm driving, I can't drink. The mom started taking photos with me, selfies, like, and all the rest of it. And I was told the next day that she actually posted them on her Facebook. Well, anyway, so the mom got drunk at her boyfriend's house, and they then decided to go out, now clubbing. The mom came to my side and started linking arms with me, like, all like this, like, "You beautiful," and touching me and all that kind of stuff. And he got jealous or something, and he came and pushed her away. I'm like, "No, this is my date, this is my man," kind of attitude. Then the mom started walking in the middle of the street, so I had to go get out of the street because she almost got hit by a car once or twice. And I'm like, "Okay, this is interesting." So once we get the mom off the street, she comes to me. She didn't even go to her boyfriend, because her boyfriend at that point was going to a club with us. But she wasn't with her boyfriend, she was with me, and her son was fighting out of me. The mom is not old, kind of, she's in her early 40s, which made me kind of feel old, and he was in his early 20s. So we got to a first club, and they refused to let his friend in because he was too drunk. So I got on, and I love to dance when I'm out, so I started dancing, and the mom came to me, and the mom started dancing with me, and he kind of came and took over and kind of pushed the mom away, kind of attitude. And at this rate, I'm like, I'm not too sure who I came out on a date with, if it was his mom or himself, like, hello. And that happened. So because one of his friends could not get into the club, we had to leave to go to a different club. The second club we went to, again, it was a very nice club, and we all had like headphones with different channels. We had to listen to the music from the different channels, and it was all fine. We went inside drinking and dancing. Again, this his friend was too drunk, so he was kicked out, and he was having a fight outside with the security. So every 2 seconds we were being called to get his friend to safety or get him away from the security. And at one point he literally just walked off and got lost for the rest of the night. The mom got way too drunk that the boyfriend was like, "You know what, I need to take her home because she's just troublesome, she's just all over the place, so we need to take her home." So the next thing I saw was this man dragging this lady and taking her home. I'm like, yeah, this is why I prefer staying at home with my PlayStation and not all of this drama. The friend that is too drunk was now lost. So myself, my date, and his friend, the girl that was with us as well, we started going to look for this guy that is too drunk and now lost. So at this point, it was, I don't know, 3 a.m. in the morning. And I was just standing outside, like wherever, I can't be bothered anymore. And this girl from a distance started, you know, and she came over to me. I was having like this bag of chips because I was starving. And she was like, "Oh, can I have some?" I'm like, "Yeah, sure, help yourself." And she took some and walked away, and then looked at me again and came back to me. She was like, "My mom is on the phone, and she thinks I'm drunk and all, so I'm just trying to speak to my mom. Do you want to speak to her?" I'm like, "What?" She's like, "Yes, do you think you can make a first impression?" I'm like, "I don't even know you." And we started laughing. Then she walked off. My date walked to me And he was like, why are you speaking to that girl? Are you into girls? I'm like, no, well, I'm not speaking to her like that, like I'm into her. She was flirting with me and I was just, yeah, having a fun, I guess. And he was like, are you into girls? I told you you're gay. I'm like, calm down. There's no drama here. Just calm down. So it was a very, very adventurous night. Needless to say that we decided to be just friends. We didn't like do anything more than, you know, hug and stuff like that. So we decided to be just friends. And I don't think we even speak anymore because this is like a month ago now. But anyway, I just thought I should share my crazy first date, being single and out again in the market. Well, available again. I don't think I'm ready for a serious relationship, to be honest with you. I just need some company, just friends, have fun and just enjoy life. Because I don't think I'm really ready to trust and give someone my everything again. So I'm really taking it slowly and swiping left or right on Tinder once in a while. But yeah, so that is all I have for you guys today. Thank you for watching and I will see you guys next time.